Hello guys, this is Avinash and you're watching Everything Metallurgy. We have started a series of ferrous extraction iron making videos. So we'll be continuing for the next 2 to 3 videos in the same topic. After completion of iron making, then we'll get into steel making. So in the whole November, my aim is to finish off this extraction metallurgy part. Okay, so in the last video, we have discussed about the overview and the thermodynamics of the reactions that takes place. So today we'll see some more reactions, important reactions that also take place in blast furnace, and some brief introduction about blast furnace slag. So if you consider in blast furnace, the metallic iron, we are saying metallic iron or the molten iron, will be absorbing the carbon percent from the coke. Yes, because coke is the principal source of carbon that is present. So the hot metal starts absorbing this carbon into the into its molten form at the lower stack, at the lower part of the stack. What is the temperature that we have discussed? At the lower stack, the temperature will be about 1200 degrees Celsius. This is the most important part because the conversion of FeO to Fe and the melting starts from here only. Okay, so the metallic iron starts absorbing carbon in the lower part of the stack owing to the presence of coke. Owing to the presence of coke, whatever it is present in the furnace, the transfer of carbon to hot metal takes place. And because of this only, the hot metal contains about 4% of carbon. About 4% carbon will be present. We have discussed in the composition of hot metal also. About 4% of carbon is present in the hot metal. This is because to the presence of coke. And what will be the temperature? The temperature of this hot metal which contains 4% carbon will be about 1200 degrees Celsius only. If you see, the melting point of iron is 1540 degrees, but as the percentage of carbon increases, if you see in the iron carbon diagram, the melting point decreases. Always remember this. So as the carbon content in the hot metal increases, the iron making in the blast furnace can be easily take place at lower temperatures. So that is an important point I wanted to discuss. So this is about the major constituent of hot metal. Now we'll discuss about the major constituents of the slag. What is a slag? We have discussed that slag is nothing but the removal of the impurities or whatever the impurities present in the hot metal or the ore. They go and form a low density layer called slag layer, and these are generally oxides like SiO2, Al2O3, CaO, MgOA, all these oxides. So these are the major constituents of blast furnace slag, and there are other minor constituents also. These are said to be the major constituents, and there are minor constituents also like MnO, to. These are the minor constituents. That means the percentage of these are very less. So generally the SiO2 and Al2O3 come from the gangue. Gangue is nothing but the impurities present in the ore, iron ore, and also from coke ash. Always remember this, from coke ash. What is this coke ash? On combustion of coke, there are some impurities present in the coke also, which are nothing but aluminosilicates. Aluminosilicates, which again dissociate into SiO2 and Al2O3. So coke ash is an important source for these oxides, whereas CaO and MgO are nothing but these come from the fluxes. We have discussed that limestone and dolomite are added as fluxes. So these are coming from the fluxes that we are adding. So we'll be discussing more about the slag properties, basicities, viscosities, network breakers, network formers, all these things regarding slag in steel making, because there the importance of slag is more. The type of slag decides the type of reaction that is taking place in steel making. So it's better we'll be discussing all about the slag properties in steel making itself. But you must remember that the viscosity of the blast furnace slag should be less, so that if viscosity is less, the fluidity will be more and it can be easily removed. The slag can be easily removed. So remember this always. And these are the different types of oxides or the constituents that present in the blast furnace slag. Okay, we'll discuss more about blast furnace slag or the slag properties in steel making. And now today we'll discuss about the other reactions that takes place in the blast furnace. What may be the other reactions? The first important constituent other than carbon is silicon. We have seen in the composition of hot metal. So today we'll see the reaction of silicon. Okay, so first we'll consider in the raceway and the Bosch. We'll see the reactions that takes place in the raceway and in the Bosch. Okay, so generally in the raceway what happens? The coke burns in the blast furnace, that is in front of the tuyeres in the combustion zones, and these release the carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide gases, but preferably carbon monoxide gas. We have discussed this in the previous video also. And along with this, just now we have discussed that coke ash is also obtained. Coke ash is also obtained. Coke ash is nothing but the mixture of SiO2 and Al2O3. So these go into the molten slag. Yes, so some molten slag containing these high SiO2 and high FeO, I think they have forgot FeO. FeO is also an important constituent in the slag. So if these quantity is high, along with the hot metal, these also dribble down. This also drips down to the runway and forms a separate layer, and sometimes reactions takes place in these mix into the hot metal as silica. So in the presence of carbon, what generally happens is this SiO2 that is coming from the coke ash reacts from the coke again, that is carbon, forms SiO gas vapors. This is from the coke ash or slag already formed, reacts with the carbon to form SiO gas vapor plus CO gas. So this is an intermediate reaction in which this SiO2 is converting into this SiO. What happens to this, or generally sometimes these SiO2 can also react with carbon to form SiC carbide, silicon carbide may also be formed. Okay, and this will finally react again with CO and it forms SiO. So formation of SiO is what taking place at first in the raceway and Bosch. Okay, so now what happens from this SiO? The silicon gets transferred from these gas vapors into the hot metal or into the liquid iron by the reaction of this SiO with the carbon that is dissolved in the liquid iron. We have almost about 4% of carbon that is dissolved in the hot metal. So this SiO reacts with the carbon in the hot metal and it transfers the silicon into the hot metal. So if you see, this SiO gas will react with the dissolved carbon. These brackets, always wherever in steel making or iron making, if these brackets are there, it is nothing but it is in the dissolved form, it is in the dissolved condition. It gives rise to this thing. It dissolves the silicon and produces CO gas. Okay, so because of this reaction, the silicon content increases. or otherwise some other reactions may also take place. This gas may decompose to form SiO2 plus dissolved silicon, or sometimes if there is FeO in slag, it also may react with this gas vapor, and again it forms this. Okay, so first two reactions, the dissolved content of silicon in the hot metal increases. But whereas if you see the second and third condition, the SiO2 formed will always go into the slag phase. Okay, so what is the condition? What is the major condition to decrease the content of silicon or to improve the desiliconization from this reaction? If you see, what is the content or what is the condition that it should be required? It is nothing but it requires high blast pressure. I'll explain why. Always remember this, high blast pressure is required such that to decrease this. Okay, just recall and tell me the reaction that is taking place in the formation of SiO. SiO is forming from the reaction of SiO2 from either coke ash or from the slag. From either coke ash or from the slag, it reacts with the carbon or the coke and it forms what? SiO gas vapor plus CO gas. So if you see this reaction, this is a solid, this is a solid. So if you see the gas moles, number of gas moles, there are zero this side and there are two this side. Yeah, so according to the Le Chatelier's principle, if we increase the pressure, and one more thing, where this temperature, I mean where this reaction is taking place, this reaction is taking place at the tear region. So at the tear region, the main pressure that is there is from the blast. The pressure that is coming is from the blast. So consider high blast pressure. So what happens according to Le Chatelier principle, if the pressure is increased, the reaction moves from high moles direction to low mole direction. That means high mole is 2 and low is 2. So on increase of this high blast pressure, what happens? The backward reaction of this takes place. So that means the formation of this SiO is suppressed. Therefore, obviously, this reaction will not take place. Okay, so always remember high blast pressure is required in order to increase the desilicalization or to reduce more silicon content from the hot metal. So these are the different reactions that take place in the raceway and in the Bosch at higher temperatures, at about 1900 to 2000 degrees Celsius, this happens. Yes, now we'll see the reactions that takes place in the earth. Same the reaction in the earth. Okay, so here what happens is the molten metal droplets reacts with the slag in the earth while passing through the slag layer. Obviously there will be some slag layer and the metal will be dripping down, and while this metal dripping down to the bottom, there will be some reaction that will be taking place between the molten metal and the slag phase. So here if you consider this reaction of silicon, the slag and metal reaction, we call it a slag metal reaction, will be the SiO2 that is present in the slag. These brackets indicate the liquid or molten form with the again dissolved carbon, and again it forms dissolved silicon into the hot metal and 2CO. Okay, so this is the reaction that will be taking place in the slag metal reaction, and sometimes it can also reduce other oxides, like for example, if you see in this case, this is the dissolved silicon. It is reacting with the MnO that is present in the slag, and it is increasing the Mn content and removing the Si as SiO2. Okay, so these are the different conditions that may be, or these are the different reactions that may be taking place at the Earth region. Okay, so one main effect we have discussed how to reduce the silicon content. Yes, so why we have to decrease this? We are decreasing the silicon content because the same thing we have discussed for efficient steel making, for efficient refining of the hot metal, the impurity content should be less. So it can be done by first one is high blast pressure. We have discussed just now. Next is decreasing the extent of SiO formation. How? By lowering the ash content. If the ash content is low, the SiO2 that is coming from coke ash will be low. Yes, so by lowering this ash content of coke, the hot metal composition of Si also decreases. What else? The decreasing silicon absorption by liquid iron in the bath by enhancing the SiO2 into the slag. This is achieved by increasing the slag basicity. We'll discuss this point. Please remember this, that to remove slag, oh sorry, to remove the silicon from the hot metal, the slag basicity must be increased. Why? I'll explain briefly. Slag basicity is nothing but the ratio of basic oxides to the ratio of acidic oxides. If slag basicity is high, the amount of acidic oxides that are present in the slag are less. So, according to Le Chatelier principle, again, if the product is decreased, the reaction will forward, I mean, the reaction goes in forward direction. So, because of that reason only, if the SiO2 content in the slag is decreased, the formation of SiO2, new SiO2 is enhanced. So, increasing the slag basicity also decreases the silicon in the hot metal. So, these are the different types of, or these are the different measures that can be done in order to form liquid metal with low silicon content. Okay, so this is about silicon. We have discussed the reactions in the silicon, how to decrease the silicon composition also we have discussed here. So now we'll be discussing the other important reactions. There are some important reactions that I'll be noting down here. So these FES and CAS are coming from the coke ash again, as calcium and iron has a good affinity with sulfur. It reacts with other SiO vapor and carbon to form calcium sulfide, sorry, silicon sulfide. Okay. Where this silicon sulfide, it is a gas similar to SiO, and this SiS will again dissociate into Si and sulfur. So these are the reactions of sulfur that take place at the Bosch and runway. Okay, I'm saying Bosch and runway because at that temperature only, or at that region only, the coke ash is generated, or the slag, yes, the slag is generated. So these are the reactions. Firstly, from the coke ash, whatever is the sulfide there, it reacts with the SiO gas vapor, forms SiS gas vapor, and it dissociates because of the high temperature into dissolved silicon and dissolved sulfur. This is the reaction of sulfur that is taking place at the Bosch or the runway. In the hearth, what happens in the hearth generally? We saw that the slag metal reactions takes place in the hearth region. Yes, the slag metal region. So the dissolved sulfur in the metal reacts with the oxides that are present. Slag is nothing but the oxide. So this ion, this dissolved sulfur, will be oxidized, sorry, will be reduced by these oxides that are present in the slag, and the dissolved oxygen content increases. So this is the slag metal reaction of sulfur in the hearth region. It is in the hearth region. Okay, the dissolved sulfur reacts with the slag, the oxides that are present in the slag, and it forms S-2 and dissolved oxygen. Okay, so these are the reactions that takes place, and there are some other reduction reactions also, reduction of other oxides. Like if you see the reduction of MnO that is present in the slag, this is a similar reduction reaction. These are nothing but the minor constituents of the slag. Okay, it reacts with the coke, and generally these are formed. Okay, so these are nothing but the general reactions that takes place in the blast furnace. Apart from the principal reactions, these reactions are important because the main constituents or the main composition of hot metal is decided by these, all these reactions only. Okay, so it is important. What else we have discussed? We have discussed about the melting point of iron. As the carbon absorption increases, it melts at about 1185 degrees Celsius only, to be precise. It melts at about 1185 degrees Celsius. And the hot metal has 4% carbon. Okay. So in the cohesive zone, we'll discuss what a cohesive zone is in the next video. The coke is the only source of carbonization of liquid iron. That means whatever is the carbon that is going into the liquid iron, that comes from coke. Yeah. Whatever is the source, that is nothing but coke itself. But this carbon directly will not dissolve. This carbon will not directly dissolve into the liquid iron. Whatever is the gas that is formed, for example, CO is the major gas that is formed, this dissociates into the dissolved carbon plus CO2. Okay, so this is the possible mechanism that is taking place. As carbon directly cannot melt, as its melting point is also very high, the possible mechanism of carbonization is nothing but the increase in the carbon content, is only by the CO that is formed by the gasification of carbon. Whatever gasification or the combustion takes place, from that CO only this dissolved carbon is formed. Okay, so these are the different reactions that takes place. One more thing, guys, I forgot, is iron making has only two more videos left. So after this, we'll be moving on to the steel making part. So please like this video to give me some motivation, and please subscribe and share to all metallurgy gate aspirants so that they'll be benefited by my videos. Thank you, guys. Have a nice day.